new horses to your herd. People amendment horses as typically as they purchase new cars lately. New horses are always coming and going. Their square measure those that have had 5 to 7 horses in as a few years. Many of these new horses already. People modification horses as typically as they purchase new cars recently. New horses are always coming and going. Their square measure those that have had 5 to 7 horses in as a few years. Many of these new horses already know how to behave in the herd. They skills to yield to the dominant horse, how to read posture, how to get out of the way, when to back down, and how to be a horse. Unfortunately, many of our pampered pets don't know a whole lot about being a horse, and this can get them into trouble when they most need it. Since you can't ask the horse, it can be difficult to determine how your new horse is going to act with an established herd. So it's better to be safe and control this introduction a bit than to deal with veterinary bills and frustration. It's always best to quarantine or keep a brand new horse break free your established herd till you're certain that the new horse is freed from unwellness or the other malady. When the horse is set to be in physiological condition, then it's fine to begin the process of introducing him to the herd. Many people that will not let their horses be with another horse as a result of they're afraid they will get hurt or that they're too valuable. Sure, obtaining herd is usually a risk. Horses square measure a number of the foremost accident-prone animals on the earth. But, like our children, we can't always protect them from everything. No doubt they are doing price heaps of cash, but horses are herd animals and they value the companionship of another horse more than just about anything else. Their square measure varied ways that to introduce a brand new horse to the herd. Many people simply throw the new guy out into the pasture and let him work it out with the established herd. This can work. Horses are doing this on their own for years before we tend to ever got concerned. This methodology works best if you have got heaps of area for the horses to utilize their inherent gregarious traits a bit like they might within the wild. But, if you have got a confined space wherever territory has been established, chain of command, friendships, etc. Then you will need to intervene so as to regulate the success of the new horse in establishing himself within the herd. If you only have one horse and you're transfer in another one, you'll probably have two very relieved horses and your job won't be too big. Horses square measure herd animals and it takes quite one to be a herd. It's very not a good deal to stay a solitary horse. Many times you will be stunned that if you throw the new guy out with the others that he'll go stand by himself and wait till he's invited in by the dominant horse. However, if you have got one horse to integrate with several others, which is a lot of likely, then you will have some problems. It's probably that the resident horse's square measure about to set the tone for behavior. Horses will quickly verify wherever they work into the dominance food chain on their own. They grasp their station in life, but they are also always trying to improve their status. Horses don't have anything however outing within the pasture, they are doing this all day with different horses, flicking their heads, displaying dominant posture, and even kicking and biting when they want. It's a necessity to bolster their position within the herd. Leaders get used to leading. Expect that a horse United Nations agency was dominant in an exceedingly herd that he last came from goes to undertake to regain this standing with the new herd. Spoiled horses or horses that haven't had a lot of horse-to-horse interaction however have had heaps of horse-to-human interaction might not skills to behave within the herd surroundings. It's not your job to show them, but it is your responsibility to have a horse that knows how to yield to another. By having them within the herd, they are forced to play by horse rules? They have to yield to the dominant horse or risk the results. This is one amongst the most effective ways in which I do know of to show a spoiled horse United Nations agency is ambitious with folks the way to be a horse. The common problem technique. Before trying these techniques you ought to be ready to interpret a horse's angle, posture, and have the abilities to figure in an exceedingly spherical pen. My favorite method of introducing a new horse to the herd is by giving all of the horses a common problem to work out. I sometimes place 3 to 4 horses into a spherical pen or arena and work all quickly with the new horse. If you merely have one horse, this is often still an honest exercise to introduce one horse to another. The common problem that we are talking about is you. You need to ask them to do things that focus on you as the leader. Ask them to change directions, get them to draw into you, hook on, move their feet like you want, etc. Make them all work. This gets their mind off their horse games that they play with one another and onto you. Look for signs that that herd is accepting the new horse. If you see any inappropriate behavior, i.e. kicking, biting, etc., raise all of them to figure some a lot of. If the behavior is sweet, reward them by letting them stand still. It will take 2 to 3 sessions, or it should take more before your horse is totally integrated with the opposite horses. Don't rush the introduction. It may appear that the horses get along pretty well after the first time, but it's probably a mistake to do this once and throw them all out together. Your time is well spent to try and do this right and not rush the introduction. Once you can see that the horses openly accept one another without any stress or pressure from you, it's probably okay to put them out together. Don't get too involved. Let the horses determine what their herd standing will be. You may be able to do this for a few minutes while you have the focus of the herd, but you're just wasting your time. The minute you permit, the horses are going to work this out on their own. Obviously, if a horse is getting the tar beat out of him by another, you should get them working. Remember to stay safe. Don't insert yourself in the middle of the action. If you have got to induce big to stay the horses from running over you, then no. This is wherever you're establishing your leadership role with the herd. If the horses are moving you out of the means, you probably shouldn't be the one doing this exercise. And simply just in case, I always carry a rope or progress string that I can use to send energy to a horse that isn't playing by the rules. You may have over one horse to integrate, which will be through with these techniques. After a short time, the new guy are integrated into the herd as a result of he has been operating with the opposite horses to downside solve. You may have several horses to try and do this during a spherical pen. It's important to know that the more horses you work with, the harder this is to do. It's not a good idea to work more than 5 to 6 at a time with this technique in a confined area. Any more than that and it's hard to keep up with all the action. You can use associate arena, tiny enclosed space, and even a small pasture. A spherical pen isn't necessary. What's important is that you control the interaction of the horses. The buddy system, the slow and easy technique. Assuming that you simply have on an individual basis enclosed areas to stay horses safely separated, another technique that you simply will use is to place the new horse into a stall or pen at intervals sight of the others. This way he will visit from a distance and watch the interaction of the opposite horses. The new horse can study the others' behaviors and learn what the herd hierarchy is from a distance before he gets into the combination, and also the herd gets a chance to check him out too. Pick one horse to introduce to the new guy too and focus on building a relationship between the two of them. Start by walking the new horse by the other horse just so that they can see each other. Stop and permit them to smell one another, but don't let them interact at first. This is easier if you are doing the introduction on neutral territory. Go on a path ride, take them to a friend's house, work cattle, go to another barn, arena to ride, etc. There is nothing like operating along to bring two horses along during a common bond. Eventually, you're about to place the two of them along during an enclosed space. For the sake of safety and also the ability to manage true, you may still want to use some form of the common problem technique in order to freely introduce the two horses. The wide open spaces technique. Provided you have got tons of unhampered area, you may be able to throw the new horse in with the established horses and let him work it out with the established herd on his own. Nothing new here, horses are doing this on their own for years. A good rule of thumb would be one horse per acre of land. You need extra space to permit for the horses to maneuver, send horses out, invite horses in, etc. You risk more kicks, bites, and other injuries with this method. But, your personal safety is less at risk. Even if you decide that this is the way you want to go, it's still a good idea to work the horses in order to get their mind off of the horse games with each other. If you'll ab initio get the horses to specialize in you, they're going to be additional probably to quickly settle for the new horse due to his cooperation with the others. Many horses don't know how to be horses. We have a gaggle of mares that we tend to use to institute herd behavior with our new horses. There's nothing higher than a longtime band of mares. United Nations Agency won't tolerate spoiled behavior to show a young horse a way to behave. They learn about posture, yielding, respect, patience. All of the items that you simply wish the horse to know with you as their leader. It doesn't matter where they learn it. What's vital is that the horse will perceive herd behavior and the way to be a horse. Your job is then easy? All you have got to try to do is learn the way to speak with the horses to become their leader. Set yourself up for success. Use common sense. With any of those techniques, you will have better results if you set yourself up for success. When you feed, scatter the food around so that the horses don't have to eat on top of each other. You'll avoid tons of accidents by deframing simply a bit longer. Make sure that you simply have shelter for all of your animals. If you do not have enough protection, then you'll need a number of them trying to push others out into the weather. Establish a good quarantine program so that you don't introduce any disease, sickness to your other horses. Stallions should not be introduced into a herd under any circumstances unless you know what you are doing. Young horses shouldn't be introduced into a new herd until they are strong enough to fend for themselves. Sick, wounded, and/or previous horses could also be more happy doing their own issue instead of creating them. Got to take care of the fine points of herd behavior. You can introduce horses across a boundary line, between stalls, on the trail, or working. There's a heap to be gained in these specific cases by ensuring that these horses have the power to check the opposite horses and might visit from a distance without causing any harm or being hurt. A horse does not essentially got to be within the same enclosed space because the others to be a part of that herd.